This will be the only forum, the only space in which the capital's black communities can hold our mayoral candidates to account. Right here in Ruach Church. Give a round of applause. A debate in which you will demand, you will not ask, you will demand from our candidates to begin in no small measure to address your concerns. We can talk about those concerns during this debate, but this is our space, in a special place, to have a conversation about London governance in which you are key stakeholders.
It is not enough to put a mayor in office. We have to be represented throughout the entire term. So if you are with me on that simple decision, I want you to make some noise in Ruach Church. And it is noise that is saying, not only do we have the power to decide who gets in office, but once you get in office, you will not forget us. We will not be forgotten. Can I hear an amen?
I believe we will transform this city when we start engaging with our young people in a positive way, and we don't do that at the moment. Our education system in London is flawed, and it leaves people behind, it leaves the most vulnerable people behind. I have an education strategy, please look at it. I would appoint a young mayor for London, and I would create a new youth assembly for London and give young people a real voice right at the heart of London. That's how we're going to start transforming this city.
We have got to transform London. There is too much discrimination in the police. There is too much discrimination in employment. There is, as Siobhan says, education system is not engaging every young person, and it needs to. I promise you, I have a reputation that I'm going to live up to for telling the truth, for standing up for diversity, for standing up for the black community. And if you vote for me as your mayor on the 3rd of May, I promise you, I will be listening to you like I did in Brixton. I will be acting on what you say, and it will be a better London as a result. Thank you.
There's a small number of things this mayor can do can make a big impact on ordinary Londoners' lives. One is to cut the fares. We have the highest fares in the world. For all the noise you hear from the bankers, the biggest increase in unemployment, 2/3 of all the jobs we've lost in the city have been in construction. And yet we've got people who will die before they get to the top of their council waiting list. I want to start building homes. Take someone out of squalid accommodation. Give each child a bedroom where they can do their homework. They'll do better at school, they have more chance of getting a job.
And the Green Vision for London is of a more equal, a more healthy, and a more affordable city. I want to help all Londoners flourish. London is the most unequal part of the UK. A fifth of people here in London still work for less than the London living wage. That is absolutely inappropriate in a city as rich as London. And a tiny minority at the top get these inflation-busting pay rises and show absolutely no concern about what's happening to people who are sinking into poverty. So as mayor, I will take action against this growing pay gap. For example, at the Greater London Authority, I will ensure that nobody is paid less than 10% of what the top person earns.
We have not only put 1,000 more officers on the streets of London, more uniformed officers, more warranted officers than there were when I was elected, but we're going to put 2,000 now, 2,000 more in our safer neighbourhood teams. That's three police constables and three specials in every one of our 634 wards in our city. And yes, I want to see more young people get the apprenticeships that they need. We've done 54,000 already. We're going to go on to 100,000 by the end of this year. We can do 250,000, we think, in the next mayoral term. But I'll tell you something, in a city that was plagued with riots last August, we need to do more to get those young people ready for apprenticeships and ready to get into employment, don't we?
One of the greatest things I've always believed in is the power of your own convictions. In this room, albeit we said Black Britain decides, you look around and you see we're not just black people in this room. We are London. And it's London that will make that decision as to who is our mayor. Your voice, what our vision must be that we will build a united city. A city where blacks and whites can work together and achieve the goals that we have, and we will not be discriminated against. That's why we've had to say Black Britain decides.